I'm joined now by NBC News' global correspondent, Willem Marx. Willem, good to have you with us. So what do we know about how these two companies partnered up to try and develop this vaccine?
Well, Eamon, it's really the German company's proprietary biotechnology that's been key to this breakthrough. That technology relies on something called messenger RNA, mRNA. And that occurs naturally in all of our bodies. It's essentially a long molecule made up of building blocks, sometimes hundreds, sometimes thousands of them, called nucleotides. And it works like an instruction manual for our cells. It essentially is introduced to a cell and instructs it how to act. And so what they've done with this particular vaccine, they've tweaked the mRNA and they've made it into an instruction manual for the cells, telling them to create a specific protein, an immunogen. And you might have heard about the spike protein over the last few months. That's what this does. It encourages the cells to create spike proteins, which in turn provoke an immune response in our bodies, and that means that antibodies are created. They can attack the virus if it shows up in our system. What's so encouraging about this recent data is that so many of the other vaccines in development also try to target that spike protein. So experts say this is a really hopeful set of data we've got this week. I've been speaking to some of the doctors and scientists involved in this Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine, speaking to them about this recently. And what I spoke to one of the men about this, Mark Mulligan, he runs the NYU Langone Vaccine Center. He's the director there. He's been treating some of these patients. He said that as the underlying basis, not just for this vaccine, but all future vaccines, what's so incredible about this mRNA technology is it can be tweaked and built upon as required. Take a listen.
The revolution will come in that it's a very rapid platform. Once you have the superstructure, if you will, you can slot in a new gene, whether it's, you know, for HIV or Zika or something else, once you've got the superstructure for the RNA.
So, Eamon, the platform that supports this potential vaccine that could hopefully combat this pandemic is so important because it could be a platform that could form the basis of weapons for all future vaccines to fight all future viral pandemics.
What an incredible breakthrough. All right, Willem Marx, thank you very much for explaining it to us. I actually was able to understand it. I was worried that perhaps the science would be a little bit too much, but that makes sense. Willem Marx live in London. Thanks, Willem. For more on this, I want to bring in Dr. Mario Ramirez, the former acting director of the pandemic.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.